Dear students, today we will discuss join operations in databases. So the join of two relations produces a new relation whose attributes consist of the attributes from the original relations. So let's have a practical example. We have two relations. One has registration number, name and father name, and another has registration number and marks in introduction to computing. So you can see that you can also say that this is one file being stored at a university, all right, and this is second file stored at an examination department. So when we want to join these two relations, so we want to produce one relation like this one. And you can see that in this joining, we have registration number common in both of the relations. So we will join based on this registration number. And you can see that these are two registration numbers. Their name and father name are coming from first relation, and the marks are coming from the second relation. So this is one typical example of joining based on some criteria that the join will be performed based on common attributes known as registration number. So let's elaborate further that how can we join different tables or relations in databases. So for example, relation A contains attributes V and W. When it is joined with relation B that contains attributes X, Y and Z, then as a result, the new relation will have 5 attributes, and the names of those attributes would be A dot V, A dot W, B dot X, B dot Y, and B dot Z. This naming convention ensures that the attributes in the new relation have unique names, even original have same names. So for example, if both relation have V, so in the resultant there would be a confusion that this V is representing to which relation, either the first one or the second one. So we will add the relation name before it, like A dot V or B dot V. So what will happen with the tuples? So the tuples, rows of the new relation are produced by concatenating tuples from the two original relations. Which tuples are actually joined to form tuples in the new relation is determined by the condition under which the join is constructed. So let's have two examples to elaborate it. So in this example, we are interested to form a new relation C, and the condition is join A with B where A dot W is equal to B dot X. And you can see that this is relation A, this is relation B, and this is W column, and this is X column. So which means wherever this column and this column are equivalent, then it should be joined. So first of all, first row will be picked from here, and it will see that whether this 2 is appearing over here somewhere or not. So we can see yes, this 2 is available over here. So it will be joined R2 to MQ. So this first line is formed. Then the next will be taken from here. So T4, here we have 2 4s, one is here and one is there. So here we will have 2 rows. So T4 4 DE is the next line, and then T4 4 TF is the third line. So this means that how many tuples will be there based on this condition which we have over here. So let's have another example where we have changed this condition. So now we are interested in where A dot W is less than B dot X. So we will pick first 2. So you can see that this one is not less than. So this condition will be false. So this 4 is okay. So 4D will become first line. Then 2 is not less. 2 5 is okay. So this will become second line. Then this 4 will be picked. So 4 is not less than 1, 4 is not less than 4, 4 is not less than 2, 4 is less than 5. This is perfect. So this would be the third line. And then the next line will be picked, that is P6. So this 6 is not less than 1, is not less than 4, is not less than 2, is not less than 5. So there will be no tuple coming over here. So you have seen that this number of tuples is based on the conditions which we are imposing over here. So let's summarize today's module. We have learned that how join operations can be performed in databases, what happens when two relations are joined in terms of attributes and data, and we have discussed two examples to illustrate the difference.